welcome back to Angela Bishop, who's in London. She was, of course, in London for when the Queen passed away. But, Ange, it wasn't actually royalty that took you to the UK. Can you explain what happened?
Well, not real royalty. It was Hollywood royalty. A lot of our viewers on our Facebook page were asking, how did I come to be here so quickly, you know, when the news came that the Queen passed away, because I was on air about an hour and a half later, 2 hours later. And that's because I was actually in London interviewing the incredible George Clooney and Julia Roberts. Now, you might remember they filmed a movie up in Queensland a short time ago called Ticket to Paradise, which is absolutely fabulous. It's a rom-com. And it was absolutely great to catch up with them, as well as some of the others in the cast, including Billy Lord, Catelyn Deaver, Lucas Bravo, and the writer and director, Ol Parker. Take a look. Don't show up,
don't come out. You did look as though you were having so much fun filming this that I really asked the question, should you have been paid?
We weren't.
Ah.
So that worked out.
We don't get paid when we're together.
Oh, no, is that the deal?
Well, no, we got paid at the end to leave.
I'm sorry. I think your things are in my seat.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, come on.
You've got to be kidding me.
I've flown in from Australia this morning.
Do you have biscuits in there?
Yeah. I thought there might be some things you'd be missing.
Tim Tams.
Oh!
Oh, yes.
One for
oh
you.
Oh, my God.
You.
I'll one take yours. I'll hold on to it.
I got some Bluey merch for the twins.
Oh, there we go. What is it? Oh, see, now I'm...
I thought you might be missing those things.
Yes. You have no idea.
I'm not even giving those to the kids. I'm playing with
them. I freeze. I'm Batman.
The last time I saw you on the Gold Coast was for Batman.
That's right. I showed up for a press tour and to just get beaten by everyone for doing that film.
Not at all. It was fun and games.
Excuse me, ma'am. I need to sit somewhere else. We used to be married.
Worst 19 years of my life.
We were only married for 5.
I'm counting the recovery.
Open up the window.
Did you have an amazing time filming?
Yeah, we loved it there. I spent a lot of time there. I was there longer than you would imagine for Thin Red Line as well. And yeah, I love the Gold Coast. It's really beautiful down there and stuff. So I've always had a great time.
People were friendly wherever we went. The weather was beautiful, sometimes a little hot.
There is something about the creatures in your country. Everything is huge.
There are plenty of them.
The spiders are like that big. Yes. Everything, the frogs
There's
are poisonous.
There's no sleeping past a minute past dawn.
Let's go.
Can we get something a little more age appropriate for these two?
What adventures did you get up to in Australia that you can tell me about?
So many adventures.
Golf, karting,
golf
all
karting
around.
Everywhere. We went to the Great Barrier Reef.
And did you see dolphins and stingrays?
We went on a windy day.
Visibility. We knew the Great Barrier Reef was there.
Yeah, we did. We felt her presence.
2 hours
beautiful.
Journey.
2 hour journey, 2 hours back. Really good. We had a good cheese plate and a beer. Also, my Australian accent is...
Oh, yeah, quick. Give me something.
All right. What do you want to talk about?
Oh, that's quality.
Yeah, it's not bad.
That's, no, I'm paying that.
Yeah. Spent a lot of time there. I love the people.
She's good. I gave all my Tim Tams away to Julia. I couldn't.
Oh, what?
You brought Tim Tams?
Love.
That is not okay.
Try to keep the snoring down.
I have a nasal strip.
It's a mystery you're still alone.
How much fun was this movie? You get the gig, you're told I'm playing Julia Roberts' love interest. That's a good day at the office.
It's yeah, it's exactly, I think it's exactly it. Sometimes I would be on a private island with white beach and turquoise water and George whispering jokes and Julia smiling and you're just like, I can't believe this is, I'm getting paid for this.
So you sent back the money?
I sent back the money and canceled my flight.
Happy couples about to stand up there. The ring bearer brings two rings that have been blessed by the hat guy for them to exchange. But if they don't, it messes with the whole right place, right time.
So
right,
we steal the rings.
I was about to say that.
But you didn't, so it's my idea.
Okay.
The other thing that's great about this is it's a rom-com. And in the world of non-stop lycra, it's nice to see something like this again, isn't it?
It is refreshing. You know, it was invented for entertainment and escapism. It feels good to get back to that a bit.
Well, you do it a bit. You know, Emily in Paris is a bit of escapism. And Mrs. Harris goes to bed. A lot of Paris movies. It's
if
a
there's,
bit
you
Paris
know, I saw
projects.
My agent. If there's Paris in the title, just send it my way.
You're in.
Yes.
Mom, Dad, this is G'day.
Om swastiastu pa. Om swastiastu me.
Om swastiastu kade.
Hey.
You learned that to make me look bad.
You don't need my help there.
What I love is you sit down and you write this script and you decide that it's perfect for Julia Roberts and George Clooney. What if they hadn't said yes?
There was no plan B. There was no... I would have just... I mean, I wrote the part in Mamma Mia for Cher. And when I got the gig for Mamma Mia, I was just a writer and I wrote in the script this part's to be played by Cher. And she turned it down four times, I think. And each time I just wrote back going, no, I'm sorry, there seems to be some confusion here because we're shooting in September and you'll be there. And so that was my only plan with these guys. When we sent it to them, we sent it to both of them together. And I said, I've written this for you and Julia, so if one of them had said no, the other one would have said no.
And...
You had George and Julia doing some amazingly fun stuff. That dance scene, were they method?
They were. No, that's not Iraq that they're drinking.
Dad, stop doing that!
We did the first take and he breaks into his moves and we talked about the moves he might do, so I had a sense, but the kids at the other side of the table, Billy and Max and Caitlin, were knocked back by his level of commitment. And once he'd done that, then you can only, you know, everyone has to match it.
We were stone cold sober. And I thought we seemed amazingly s**t-faced.
Yeah. Well,
nice. Another Australian word.
I did a little on the side when she wasn't looking.
He did it. We were stone cold sober as judges, because also it was very hot that night, so we were sweaty.
Yeah.
And it came off so convincingly.
Well, the kids were truly embarrassed.
They were in shock.
They literally were watching us like going... And we're like, come on, man, dance! And they're like, oh. It was like they were our children.
They were full method. I had to do some of my best acting ever because in reality it was hilarious and incredible, and I had to pretend like it really wasn't that incredible. But I got to like have a few happy reactions. You really had to act up a cliff.
I had to be embarrassed.
It was hard.
How long has it been?
2 days. I feel like I'm gonna die.
It's the worst feeling in the world. But I can help with that.
You can?
I got 10s, 20s, and 40s.
Caitlin, we've seen you do some pretty harrowing roles recently, particularly your work in Dope Sick, which is extraordinary.
I know I don't feel anything at all anymore.
Isn't he amazing?
Oh, maybe drops her.
Dad.
Come on, let's go.
So this must have been like a nice trip to Australia, a rom-com.
It really was.
We're vibing.
It really, we were vibing the whole time.
We were vibing, the capital B, 100%. If
you
don't
want to see me. Hey, Billy, you said it. This movie has wit and cynicism and snark.
Yeah.
Are they things you really like? Because Australians love it.
It's all I care about. I'm the most sarcastic, horrible, dark person ever. And even though I'm in this pink, like, happy dress, but that's my favorite type of humor, and this movie is filled to the brim with that, which is what I love about it.
Well, the hard stuff was always your thing. My thing was taking out the garbage and getting things off of high shelves.
Not that high, really. Mm.
You're bringing back the rom-com, which is what we need right now. Is that what you were feeling when you started to make it?
Oh, absolutely. When we read it, we were like, this is what we want. It's what our spouses want. It's what our friends want.
Yeah.
And we just hope that everybody else feels the same way.
Yeah.
A rom-com for people not in their teens, not in their 20s, or a bit grown up.
What are you trying to say?
Just saying
you're
a
just
bit grown
saying
up.
Like it's older.
That we're in our 50s. It's okay.
You're in your 50s?
Yeah.
I'm not in that guy. I'm a little further north, which is not fun.
59 and a half.
Yeah.
It but, is you know, fun. It's better than
the alternative,
which is, you know, dead.
Yeah. Pushing up daisies.
Yes, that's the name of my new book.
I'm praying for an asteroid.
Aw, fun.
Yes. So much fun catching up with them. And it's great to see Julia Roberts in a rom-com again. She's, you know, the queen of them. We haven't seen her do one. That smile is still there and still works. And the chemistry with George is amazing. Billy Lord, of course, is Carrie Fisher's daughter, Debbie Reynolds' granddaughter, who I was talking to there.
Yes.
When she said she loves sarcastic, biting humour. She is so funny and divine. She's her mum's daughter, can I say. A lot of her mannerisms and so forth. I interviewed Carrie a bunch of times, just reminded me of her. She's an astoundingly funny actor as well. She's just brilliant. And Caitlin Dever's getting all the awards attention as well. So, yeah, it's just fun, you know. It's a rom-com, backed it is, and it's in cinemas tomorrow.
Jeez, you've had a wild few days, yeah. And whoa. OK, thank you. We'll see you soon.